And if you remember, that was the first time the phrase black market judgment was used in this country. Now, the essence of that judgment was to assist the military in finding some legitimacy in perpetuating the fraud against the Nigerian people.
Even though the ground set of opinion was on the tide was against them.
Recall also that it took a number of other corresponding legal actions. That one happened in Abuja. But there were a couple of other legal actions here in Lagos, in Ibadan, to ensure that the election went on. In the mix of that confusion, it played into the calculus of the military that took advantage of the one they wanted, picked the judgment that suited the game plan, and then threw this country into the kind of confusion that we have never witnessed.
5 years on, because, I mean, they've talked about judicial reform for ages,
yes,
even before the ACJA.
Yes.
And even recently, we've seen some politicians use the same phrase, yes, black market injunction. Mm. And so, have we progressed? Are we moving forward, or we don't seem to have learned lessons, particularly for judiciary?
Yes, I'll tell you that we have made some progress. And those progress are not simply because it had to happen. It benefited from some of those crises of the past. And to, like I said, it was a very sore moment for the country.
Are there significant progress?
No, they cannot be, because the judiciary itself is not alienated or isolated, or if you like, immune from the general the general's state of the nation.
But should that be the case? If they say it's a noble profession, the hope of the common man, the last hope, so why should that still be the case?
I have told you that it took more than just the knowledge of the law and the ethics of the profession to be able to operate a functional judiciary under the military. Please don't forget that times were in this country when it took also the judiciary to state the law and pronounced on justice, even if the heavens were to fall. I'm talking of a very popular case, the military governor of Lagos State, Andojuku. It took men of courage like Honorable Justice Chukwudi Fuoputa, Kayode Eshoos of the old, to give it directly to the military government then, that you cannot be above the law, and that there cannot be a matter pending in court and you're running amok with your activities as though we're no longer in a society.
Why have we not seen the plethora of those fine gentlemen?
It is the same question that will also play out when you visit every other aspect of our situation, of our life, and then you pray that, and please, let me take advantage of this question to say that, look, whether we like it or not, for as long as we pay very little attention to the values of our people, to the standards and values of our society, for that long, we'll continue to suffer the kind of hiccups that I'll give you a practical example. In Delta State, where I come from today, and I hope I'm not digressing, every major state function and activity by the government has on the front row, I mean, has as a major state actor, Chief James Onanefeburi. From the celebration of the third anniversary of the state to the commissioning of up to 2-3 days ago. And I've had cause to call in anguish to the few persons I can recognize in those gatherings to say, why has this become the pattern? To what extent do we fully appreciate the meaning of having such a convict in front of a state action? Times where, in the past, when if you are caught stealing, you are literally ostracized from the society by women sweeping you out of to show the resentment of a society against your action. Indeed, people who want to get married are told, don't go to that family, even if it was one person that stole. The story is that there is, they steal in that family.
That takes us to citizen.
That is that. Today.
What about citizen participation?
Now,
have we learned our lessons from the past as well?
Now, whether we like it or not, that aspect of us will continue to respond to the socioeconomic conditions that we have. The resolve should be that of the Nigerian people to say that we must take our futures into our hands, retrieve that future first of all, do more than just lamenting, and organize effectively, because June 12th clearly shows that if we are united and if we are organized and coordinated, we can reach any end. But for as long as we allow the barriers created by the wrong policies of government to continue to decimate us as a people, dislocate us in one way or the other, for that long it will be difficult to get to that level that we should.
When you talked about our values,
yes,
and then you talk about policies of government, to what extent do the policies of government determine our value system?
Not too much. I say this because ideally, the values of a society ought to come from the smallest unit of that society. That is the family unit, which snowballs into the community unit, the local government, the state, and as a nation. The policies of government ought to even draw from those values, let alone setting the values itself. And therefore, where the emphasis ought to be is the kind of, you know, societal value that our youth, our young ones are made to embrace. People talk about us today. If I give you the provenance of how we all started to embrace issues of principles and character. I took my daughter to Nigerian Institute of International Affairs less than 3 weeks ago, about a fortnight ago. It was the birthday celebration of one of the heroes of this struggle, too. I'm talking of Kunle Ajibade, who was at the leadership team of the guerrilla media those days, Temple, the News, and so on and so forth. And a 12-year-old girl, she saw Professor Wolunshika, she saw Odi Alfemu, she saw even Mr. Falana, she saw a couple of other Nigerians and then when we came out, she was so excited but didn't quite appreciate that these were about the best of the brains we have, who shaped the history of this country in such a way that issues of principle, issues of character,
all right,
issues of discipline.
We'll continue from that point, yes, when we'll come back from the break in a moment. Don't go away.